Next on Expedition Central Florida, we'll be visiting Give Kids the World. Stay tuned. Good evening and welcome to Expedition Central Florida. I am your host, Steve Hansen. Tonight, we're exploring Give Kids the World in Kissimmee. Joining us on the show are Betsy Culpepper, who is Give Kids the World Communications Director, Nikki Locker, who's a volunteer at Give Kids the World, and Daniel and Cameron Fulling, who are alumni of the program, right? Say hi. Say hi to everybody.
Say hi,
Steve. Now, we're going to go over here to Betsy first.
Yes.
Tell us a little bit about how Give Kids the World got started and their purpose and all that good stuff.
Sure. Our founder, Henley Landworth, is a Holocaust survivor who made his way over to America, worked his way up through the hotel business, ended up at the Holiday Inn in Cocoa Beach, and he was also a very philanthropic man. And one of the things that he enjoyed doing is being able to help families who wanted to come to Central Florida so that they could see the attractions. He was working with one little girl's family, a little girl by the name of Amy, who unfortunately passed away before all of the arrangements could be made, and he vowed at that moment that that would never happen again. So today, Give Kids the World is a 70-acre storybook resort in Kissimmee, Florida, for children with life-threatening illnesses and their families who can come for a cost-free, week-long, wonderful vacation.
That sounds great.
It is.
I love the idea. I've actually obviously been involved with them for the past number of years in a few different ways. But Nikki, you are a volunteer there, and you do a lot more than just volunteer. So why don't you tell us a little bit about it and what the experience is like for you?
Sure. I started volunteering not too long after I started working at the Walt Disney Company. I had seen children like Cameron and his siblings walking around wearing the Give Kids the World buttons, and I wanted to know a little bit more, and that's when I found out about the whole village, and I just knew I wanted to give back to the families. So I started applying to volunteer. First it was one day, then it was three, and when I don't volunteer at the village, I actually work in the volunteer office, so very involved with it.
That's great. Now I'm going to go ahead and say hello to Cameron and Dad over there. Daniel.
How you doing?
I would just like to have you share a little bit about what the experience was like for you as a father and going to actually experience Give Kids the World. So tell everybody a little bit about what that's like.
Yeah, I would start off with, it's kind of one of those hidden treasures that nobody really knows about until one of your children or somebody you know that you love is sick. And it's just an incredible organization and destination down there in Kissimmee. Where the family, you know, we stayed actually for a week in one of the beautiful villas. I mean, incredible looking villas. I mean, I wasn't sure what we were walking into. And all the activities that they have around the village itself, as far as, I mean, the kids go to Christmas every week. So there's a Christmas every Thursday. There's different rides and different activities every day all throughout the day. One of the favorites I know is the free ice cream. So there's ice cream all day long, doesn't matter what time, every day. So the kids really tear that up. So. But it's hard to explain until you actually go out there and visit.
It is a very special place, and all of you have a very special place within that place. We're going to come back to you over
Sure.
here, Betsy. How many families does it actually accommodate at any one given time?
We have 140 villas, but we also can accommodate families off property at some of the local hotels as well. But typically, we serve about 140 families during about a week's period of time.
So 140 families a week, and I imagine there's a huge waiting list and all kinds of different...
Our busiest months, as you might imagine, are not January and September, because if you think about it, that's when kids are going back to school. So
okay.
Other than that, we're pretty much full up just about every day of the year.
And it runs a lot on sponsorship, I imagine.
We do. We are very fortunate to have some pretty incredible partners that include all of the major theme parks who were with us from the beginning, who provide the families with complimentary theme park tickets and parking and some stroller access, as well as some break areas for them during the day. So they get 3 days of Disney tickets, 2 days of Universal, one of SeaWorld, and to any other pretty much Central Florida attraction that they might want to visit while they're there for that week.
So, Dad, what was Cameron's favorite thing to do while he was down there, other than just ice cream?
At the village itself?
Yeah, at the village itself.
Yeah, I mean, he loves the miniature golf. So we did they got a little their own little miniature golf course right there on site, which is very entertaining.
I'm a golfer, so I'm with you all the way on this one.
Oh, it's beautiful. Yeah, between that and actually they have a train set, a train ride that you get on, and it tours around the village itself too. So at that time, he was big into trains, and he still loves golf, so it works out.
So Cameron, yes or no, are you a golfer? Yeah, nice work. And what kind of golf course is it? What does it have? I'm excited. Is there a windmill?
I don't believe there's not a windmill.
Okay.
There's a cave that you go into. They have a dinosaur. So there's a couple different themes going on with
Sorry,
it throughout the golf course.
My golfer in me that has to know.
Yeah. No, it's challenging. It's fun, though. It's definitely fun.
Good to hear. Nikki, you said you started out with the Disney World Corporation, and then you've slowly but surely figured your way out how to get there and volunteer. Mm-hmm. What does it do for you? What are some of your favorite moments, working day to day?
Oh, gosh. I think one volunteer said it best, that she was hoping to give the blessing at the village, but in return she received it. And I get that every day. I have a chance to work with these amazing families, the kids, the adults. It's just such a wonderful experience, the sense of laughter and hope that's leaving there, and everyone always has a smile on their face. It's contagious. You take it away from the village and you bring it back in more ways than one.
I think you hit it on the nail on the head when you said you go there thinking that you're going to help out, and then in return you leave feeling so fulfilled. I mean, it's getting me emotional just thinking about it, because it really is such a neat place.
It is.
The families that you help.
Yes.
Not just local families.
They come from all over the world. We serve about 7,000 families each year, and they truly do come from all over.
Now, when you say come from all over, give us some ideas of locations. How far away are we
talking about? Well, I believe right now we have some families from Canada on site, but we have groups that come from Israel. I think the farthest we had someone come was maybe Brazil.
So we've got a little bit of everywhere.
A little bit of everywhere.
And you work with which organizations?
We work with 250 wish granting organizations that help arrange these trips for the families.
So the process would be someone would say, hey, we've got this child and we'd like to help them out.
And they call up, and then we actually have a volunteer vacation planning services that work with them to make sure their trip, everything happens well. So they'll take care of it.
Huge resort with all the same departments.
Just about.
Pretty
it really
much
is.
The we exact are, same
we
thing.
Think of us as the destination resort for wishes.
Excellent. Well, what are some of the actual, you've got a Castle of Miracles there?
We do. We have an amazing
Tell
Castle of Miracles.
Tell us a little bit about the Castle of Miracles.
It has an enchanted carousel on it. We also, on the carousel, we actually have two cars that can fit wheelchairs, so it's wheelchair accessible. Mm-hmm. Within the castle, that you will walk in, the first thing you'll notice is all of these stars on the sky. Each one of our wish children gets a special star, and they can write their name or a design on it. And Stellar, our star fairy, places it up into the castle sky so that child will always have a permanent place at Give Kids the World.
And recently, what have you expanded to because you've run out of Constellation Room?
About a year and a half ago, we added a star tower, because if you walk in the castle, you will see that our sky was quickly getting filled up. Mm-hmm. And this is supposed to give us about another 10 years full of star capacity for our constellations.
Now, approximately how many stars did you say you have up there right
Roughly
now?
100,000. Last year, we welcomed our 120,000th family to the village.
That's quite a few people.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And how many years has it been open?
Well, the Give Kids the World actually started in 1986, but it actually was working out of a broom closet at the Holiday Inn until Mr. Landworth was able to get the land to be able to build the village. The village opened in 1989.
How you doing over there?
Good.
You still awake? Don't you fall asleep on me. All right, you also have, how about the life-size Candyland game? Did you get to play that, Cameron? Yeah? Was that a lot of fun?
Yeah.
And what about Village Idol? Who can tell me about Village Idol?
Village Idol is the American Idol equivalent at the village. The only difference is we don't have a Simon at the village, but it's a talent show night for the families. There's karaoke, there's jokes, there's dancing. We've had some amazing stories about some of the talents that these kids have brought. I've heard children who have come up on stage and they've burped the alphabet. I've heard stories of children who have brought tap shoes from their country all the way over to the U.S. so they could tap dance for us. I've seen gymnastics. We've got kids who are the panel of judges, and everybody's a winner.
Wow. That's a lot of exciting stuff, huh? Did you get up there and sing? No, I probably wouldn't have either. I'll be perfectly honest.
We'll try it.
I would like to remind everyone at home that if you have any questions about Give Kids the World for our guests here, we invite you to call in at 1-800-901-9238. That number should be on the bottom of your screen so that you don't have to actually remember it. And feel free to call in. We would love to hear your questions. Now, is there something called Winter Wonder?
Winter Wonderland.
Why don't you tell us all about Winter Wonderland?
Winter Wonderland is every Thursday. We celebrate Christmas. We have Santa Claus. We have snow. We have a Winter Wonderland parade and lots of gifts for everyone.
I'm just going to say there better be gifts.
Of course there are gifts.
Is there a giant Christmas tree as well?
So, not a giant one. During the holidays there is, but a few that kind of walk around and talk to folks.
There's a parade.
Neat. Mm-hmm. A parade?
Filled with floats and lighting lit up very nicely for the holidays.
I love parades.
And it snows in Central Florida.
That's excellent.
Every Thursday.
Every Thursday in Central Florida it snows.
So it's today's Thursday, so it is snowing at the village right now.
It's Christmas today.
I'm missing Christmas.
Merry Christmas, Cameron.
Cameron, you didn't tell me it was Christmas. All right, so you've got Christmas on Thursday, which is a giant winter wonderland. Now, to get something off the ground like that, how many volunteers would you typically have working to, again, facilitate an event like something like that?
We fill up to 1,400 volunteer shifts every single week, and the volunteers can be as young as 12 years old. They can pick up several shifts in a day if they'd like. An event like Winter Wonderland involves a decorating team. It involves people to help write letters to Santa, decorate cookies. It's the parade cast. It takes a lot of effort to get that off the ground, but the result's just amazing.
Oh, Dad and Cameron over there, can you tell us about one of the specific experiences that you had, maybe while you were at the village or at one of the parks, but just something that really said to you, wow, this is really neat. This is a cool opportunity that we've got here.
Yeah, I mean, it was just incredible to be able to break away from the hospital, not the hospital life, but I mean, we were in the hospital for quite some time, and then be able to take him, you know, with the financial burden of being out of work and, you know, trying to get through the medical bills, and just that financial burden to be able to take him to a park so he can enjoy himself with his siblings that was probably the best vacation we've ever had. You know, and just staying at the village again, it was kind of that mindset that, you know, you're not at home with the everyday down-to-down that you're on. It was an incredible vacation. The village itself is just so amazing, and there's just something to do at all times, you know. So, well, we had a great time.
It seems like you don't even have to leave the village to have a good time.
When we were there, I was like, where are we going? You know, but I mean, they mentioned, you get the tickets to the passes to the parks, and it's an amazing organization.
And it's all stress-free, right?
Oh.
Everybody does all the organizing for you. And
yeah. Meals, or you just go get a meal every day, and ice cream we lived on, I think. So
I've heard the food is great.
Yes, the food is incredible. Mm-hmm. I know there's a few sponsors that take care of quite a bit of that. So,
is there something called a Double Dare Safari game show?
Not anymore.
Well, oops. What else do you have? I'm sure you have something that...
Well, we can kind of go through
similar.
The week.
Yeah, Sunday
is the world's largest Candyland games. We have a big street party with some of our Candyland characters that are there. Monday is Halloween, so every Monday it's Halloween at the village. Tuesday is Mayor Clayton, who's our bunny rabbit mascot. It's his surprise birthday, but don't tell him. Shh. And then Wednesday is our village idol. Thursday, we said, was Winter Wonderland. Friday is Pirates and Princesses Party. Saturday is Big Splash Bash. And Sunday, we start all over again with Candyland.
Now, the Pirate and Princess Party, is
uh-huh.
it?
Uh-huh.
Now, what goes on at that? I can only imagine it's something to have to do with Pirate and Princess.
I'll let Nikki talk about that.
Nikki, why don't you tell us all about it? We'll see
Pirate and Princesses has been my regular volunteer event for well over a year now. We actually had so many children whose specific wish was to have a tea party that now we even have a pre-party called Miss Mary, Mayor Clayton's wife. She has a royal tea party. And we have arts and crafts stations. We have a puppet show. Mayor Clayton and Miss Mary stop by and we serve tea and cookies. There's then a parade down to the Pirate and Princess party where we have princess makeovers. We have pirate makeovers. There's an activity station, lots of fun dancing. And at the very end of the night, one of our knights brings the children up on stage and all of the children become official pirates and princesses of Gift Kids the World.
I imagine that was the certificate we saw getting signed right there.
Yep.
And that's their official, I'm in the pirate club now?
Exactly.
What if the guys want to be princesses instead? They can do that, right?
Sure, of course.
All right, perfect. Just making sure. Covering all the bases. Now, this probably would be more for you.
Okay.
Because you found your own way to kind of get started with it. What would you tell everyone out watching tonight, if they wanted to be a volunteer and get started, how would they go about doing so?
Definitely. We are always accepting volunteer applications, and the way to do that is to go online to the Give Kids the World website. There is a link at the top of the page that says volunteer, and if you click on that, there's a button that says apply now. Like I said earlier, we take volunteers as young as 12 years old. If children are between the ages of 12 and 15, they do need to volunteer with an adult. But once you're 16, two cool things happen now. You get your driver's license and you can volunteer on your own. So everybody needs to fill out the application. Anybody who's under the age of 18 needs to complete a parental agreement. Everybody who's 18 and older needs to complete a very simple online background check. There's a quick orientation process, just so you understand kind of how the village operates, the basic safety information, and once that's done, you can volunteer as often as you'd like.
Awesome. Well, thank you for sharing that, and the website was?
GiveKidsTheWorld.org.
Is it GKTG or?
DW.
DW,
yeah, work with me on that one.
They'll both lead you there.
Okay, I believe we have that up on the screen, so hopefully everyone should know what that is. Is there anything about Give Kids the World? What drew you in? How did you actually get started with the organization?
I've been there for about a year and a half, and I've also worked at Disney and some other not-for-profits in town. It was kind of the culmination of my history, but also I knew our president, Pam Landworth, and it's hard to say no to Pam.
That's a good thing, right?
It's a very good thing.
She's very driven, I imagine.
It's a very good thing. But truly what drew me was being able to walk outside my office door and being able to see the mission in action. You know, you mentioned ice cream several times. Our ice cream palace is open from 7:30 in the morning until 9:30 at night. And we encourage our families to have ice cream for breakfast at least once. How many times did you all have ice cream for breakfast?
Say five at least, right?
Once
five
every day.
Seven. Yeah, probably five out of seven we were down there for.
So being able to see those faces and the kids having fun and the families enjoying and reconnecting is a reward in itself.
And I think it's great what Dad said over there about being able to go somewhere that just takes your mind off of a situation that kind of just narrows down your whole world to such a small little world that you can't get out of it. So
yeah,
it's really good.
Especially with the siblings, and when they could go as well. And I mean, they all enjoyed it, I think. I didn't mention the face painting. The face painting was, I think every day we got a different theme going on, but I think everybody got their face painted every day. So that's another
day, huh?
Event. Yeah,
another whole event. There. Speaking of events, is there something about a water park?
We have a splash garden, which is located right at our Park of Dreams pool. And it's always about 72 degrees, so it's nice and warm in the winter time. That's our Serendipity ship, which our pirate ship actually has a cool sail because it can, when it's hoisted up, it becomes a movie screen. So we show dive-in movies out by the pool. We have lots of cool pool parties. It's just a lot of fun.
You said dive-in movies?
Dive-in movies.
Now, where's the screen located? I didn't actually get
on
to see
ship.
It.
The sail of the ship is the screen. We've also shown Super Bowls out there, too, for families as well who are there in January.
That was a fun party.
That is neat. Now, in your opinion, what do you think are some of the kids' favorite things to do? I mean, I know there's a ton of stuff to do. What seem to be the most popular things that just take people away and they forget about everything?
Ice cream and the carousel.
So we're going back to ice cream.
Huh? Back to ice cream.
You know, it's a good thing I love ice cream and I love golf. I should just go volunteer every other day.
That's probably when I ask families or kids what's been their favorite part. I hear those probably more than anything. It's a carousel, and kids will get on the carousel and ride them over and over and over and over.
Really?
And change different animals that they can ride on. And you know, sometimes it's very difficult to get the kids to leave the carousel because they're having so much fun.
We could ask this guy over here. I think you know something about the carousel. Yeah? Did you have a favorite animal to ride? You want to share that with us, or is it going to be a secret?
Which one was the camera?
I don't even know what they have to ride, so I can't even pick one.
Which is your favorite animal to ride on the carousel? Remember, we did that every day, right? What was your favorite animal?
A giraffe.
The giraffe?
Giraffe.
Yeah. So you picked a couple really of tall. Them. Yeah. It was tall, right?
And I don't want to put you on the spot,
yeah.
but I feel like this is the appropriate time. Is it a special day for you today, Cameron? Do you want to tell everybody, or should I? I can do it? Okay. You're 16 today, right? How old are you?
Six.
Six. I was off by 10. That's really close. Yeah. I went to public school. It's okay. So happy sixth birthday to you, buddy.
Woohoo.
Today's a special day, right?
Yeah.
That is a really special day. That's a big deal. Did you get cake yet? No? Looks like I'm getting cake after the show.
Yeah, I think we're getting cake.
I'm pretty sure you are. And what about ice cream?
No.
He's ice cream dour at this point. He's a cupcake fan right now, so we're sure we'll have some cupcakes today.
I like cupcakes too, so I'm good with that.
Good.
Other things that you have, just to hit on a few more things here, because I believe we have all kinds of things to talk about. You have a corral, a horse corral?
We do. We have Keaton's Corral, which is open on Wednesday mornings and Saturday mornings. Mm-hmm. Horses from Misty Blue Acres and Kissimmee come over, and the kids get to ride around the corral. So many times, I mean, you know, we may take horseback riding for granted, but many times, not only is it the first time they're riding a horse, it could be the first time they're seeing a horse. And it's just a great joy to watch them
and
go around the corral.
Where are the horses located? Are they close
Misty
by?
Misty Blue Acres, yes. They're close by, okay. And they bring the horses there. Also, during Winter Wonderland, we also have a carriage ride that they provide horses for, too.
And that's covered in snow as well, right?
No, the snow actually stays on the avenue.
And the snow is on Thursday, just so I get my days correct.
Thursday, yes.
Okay.
Carriage rides are also part of Winter Wonderland on Thursdays. They go around the village. Instead, the parade goes down the center of the village.
Excellent. Mm-hmm. I'm going to go back over to you, Nikki.
Okay.
And we're going to go ahead and ask you about specifically what is your normal day. Mm-hmm. At the village, what does it entail? So everyone out there that wants to volunteer has kind of an idea. I imagine you do a number of different things, but what does your typical day entail?
Oh, goodness. Volunteer opportunities at the village start bright and early. We're serving breakfast for the families in our gingerbread house as early as 7:30 in the morning. We are providing rides on the carousel right away. We've got the castle open, Amberville open for the putt-putt, pools open bright and early. And then it's in the afternoon, we do lunchside delivery service. If the families don't want to leave their villa, we'll take lunch right to them from the convenience of their own home. And then by the afternoon, we're preparing for the next big party. Mayor Clayton, our mascot, and Miss Mary are getting all dressed up to go out and enjoy the party. And then when the party is over, Mayor Clayton and Miss Mary actually provide tuck-ins, which is a completely unique experience to the village.
When you say tuck-ins, you mean literally going to tuck them into bed?
Mm-hmm. You can think we can have four different families sign up, and either Mayor Clayton or Miss Mary will come on over to tuck the children into bed. They'll check for dust bunnies. There might be some pillow fights that could ensue, or a hop on the bed, literally. And it's such a unique experience when the comment cards from the families come on in. That's one thing I always notice, is the number of people who remember how special it was when Mayor Clayton or Miss Mary came and tucked the kids into bed.
Actually, you mentioned comment cards. I can only imagine that you get a lot of mail back to you.
We do. Families are just so grateful for the time that they were able to come and reconnect and forget for a little while some of the hardships they may be facing.
Is it all a fairly similar thank you, or is there any that stand out, or
they all stand out? I feel like that's an unfair question.
Yeah.
They really do.
So it's just a little bit of everything.
I mean, our tagline at the village is where happiness inspires hope. And we hear over and over again how the visits have inspired hope within the families as well as within the wish children.
Okay. Did we talk about Amberville?
We talked a little bit about
it. Very little bit, right?
Mm-hmm. But we have, Amberville's our train station. We actually have JJ's Express that goes around Amberville that the kids and the parents can ride on. We have Mark's Dino Putt, which Cameron mentioned was his favorite spot.
That was our seven-hole golf course,
our little putt-putt area. They have some remote-controlled boats that the kids can play with.
Those are fun.
Is a huge model train set right in the middle.
Is that the one right there?
That would be it, yes. And we have volunteers that make sure that it's maintained and kept up to date.
That's neat.
It is.
Now, Dad, we're over there. And I'm just going to touch on another thing. I know that Disney does this, but do some of the other parks as well kind of give you a little extra button or pin to wear into the parks and kind of facilitate the experience to be a little bit smoother in the park as well?
Yes.
While you're on vacation.
That there is just an incredible, makes the experience just that much more, you know, and it actually comes from Give Kids a World, the Village.
Yeah.
And the button itself, and that allows them to, I mean, I don't want to say skip the line.
But wait in a lot less of a line than they would.
A lot less of a line, yeah. Because if you think about the time that they've already dedicated to their hospital stay or their sickness as it is, it's you try to get them through and make sure they can see everything. So, but that's definitely a huge advantage. And, you know, a lot of the children have done quite a bit of waiting anyway. So.
I totally understand because, again, I've been to the parks, I've worked there, and I've had plenty of run-ins where we've all had to get together. And we've had very, very little time because we didn't know if they were going to show up or not. So it's really neat that you have that ability to kind of go and speed through everything. So thank you all for sharing your part of the story with us. We are actually out of time. I would like to thank our guests, Betsy, Nikki, Daniel, and Cameron. Thanks, Cam. If any of you have any questions that didn't get answered, please email us at wdsc@daytonastate.edu. Thank you at home for tuning in, and please join us next week for another edition of Expedition Central Florida. Thanks, everyone, for watching, and good luck, all of you. Thank you.
Thank you.